Hey there, people. Lenny Rudow here for BoatUS. And I want you to pretend right now that we're enveloped in fog, or maybe the sun just went down. Hey, we can't control what the weather's like when we shoot these videos, but today we're going to talk radar, which of course is most important when you're in conditions with reduced visibility. Radar is really critical when it comes to navigating in reduced visibility, but we want to be clear up front that we're not going to try today to tell you how to set up your specific unit or work through the user interface. Every manufacturer is a little different. Instead, we hope to simply communicate how you can use your radar to navigate more effectively when it's tough to see. Now, speaking of settings, as you go through the owner's manual and figure out how to set up your radar, you'll come across a lot of things like sea clutter, rain clutter, that you can change and manipulate to change the view on the screen. But the fact of the matter is, today's units are so good on automatic mode, most of the time, you just want to put the setting on auto and leave it there. Now, one setting you will need to worry about, and this is probably one of the most important, is range. People often want to range the radar way, way out and look dozens of miles out into the distance. But the truth of the matter is you generally want to keep your radar ranged between a fraction of a mile and 3 miles. What you really want to be concerned about and what your radar can help you with is seeing things that are really close, but not visible to the eye because of that reduced visibility. What I like to do with this particular unit is generally cruise at about a mile of range. And then every few minutes, I'll range out to 5 or 10 miles to see what's out there and then bring it right back in tight. And don't forget that as I do so, I can look at these range rings on the screen to know just how far away different targets are. Many radar offer dual range functionality, so you can split the screen and look at two different ranges at the same time. And many others will overlay the radar over the chart plotter, which I personally find incredibly helpful. If your radar has Doppler, it can actually color code targets and leave a trail behind them to let you know if they're a collision hazard or not. Generally, a red trail means it's a potential collision hazard, whereas a green trail means it's a safe target. If your radar does not have Doppler functionality, you can still figure out which way a target is going as long as you're holding a steady course just by watching it. But the truth of the matter is it's really difficult to do. It's best when you see a target in those conditions to simply give it a wide berth. Some more advanced units even have MARPA, which is Mini Automatic Radar Plotting Aid. This can tell you the direction of travel, the speed, all kinds of details about different targets that pop up on your screen. Critical element to remember, people, even though you have radar, when you're operating in restricted visibility, it's still restricted visibility. Pull back on the throttle. Keep it slow. Make sure your speed matches what's appropriate for the conditions. Now, let's just say, for the sake of argument, that I'm out on the bay, I'm running for home, I'm doing 20, 30 miles an hour, and then the fog sets in. Now, I'm familiar with these waters, so I know that I can cut this red marker and I'll be okay. I might slow down to 12 or 15 miles an hour, bring up my radar at whatever range I need to see that marker clearly, and then as I get within a few hundred yards of it, slow down even more, and zoom in even more so I keep that marker on my radar screen. Now, wait a second. Why'd I cut that marker in the first place? Well, like I said, I'm familiar with these waters. I know that I don't need any more drift than my boat requires right here. And here's the thing. A lot of other boats don't have radar. And most people will be trying to run right through the middle of the channel. I don't necessarily trust everybody else to slow down to an appropriate speed as they're cruising around with fog. So, if I know I can stay outside of the channel, I would actually prefer to. Not only does picking out the proper speed require good judgment, the same goes when it comes to recognizing that radar is not infallible. Don't forget, as your boat pitches and rolls, the beam can miss, targets can come and go. And on top of that, many small boats aren't great radar targets in the first place. As for actually becoming familiar with your specific unit, well, people, that's up to you. Meanwhile, we hope this video has helped you understand how to use radar in more general terms. Don't forget, click on the subscribe button below to see our other BoatUS videos, and have a good one out on the water.